And now, live in studio, cutting through your typical media nonsense and offering you a rational and unbiased perspective on current events and life in Tampa Bay, he's a successful entrepreneur, a real estate and finance expert, and goes to bat for you every day as your consumer advocate. Your host, Brandon Rhymes.
Yes, here we are again another day, committed to picking a fight with the mainstream media and providing you the timely truth centered around real estate, credit, finance, solar technologies, and so much more. You're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show, where our number one goal is to entertain, educate, and enlighten in hopes of helping you live a better life.
The only thing I'm addicted to right now is winning.
Now, I want you to pull out your smartphone and save our consumer advocate hotline number in your phone. It's 813-917-1894.
You used to call me on my cell phone.
813-917-1894.
Baby.
And we want you to bookmark realestateradiotampa.com. That's our blog site, website, plethora of information available there for you to take a look at our expert contributors. All of our partners have their contact information under the expert contributors tab, as well as all of our real estate listings. I'm a top listing agent with Platinum MVP Realty here in Tampa Bay. And this segment is brought to you by the Maids Cleaning Service. They do a great job of coming into our real estate properties, cleaning our properties, and they come in and out. Four fine folks are in and out, and they let you know who was there and the duration of time that they were there, and referred for a reason, and that is the Maids, the official cleaning partner of the Real Estate Quarterback Show. Let's go around the horn now. This is Intelligent Talk Radio. I've got some intelligent folks here in studio. Let's make our introductions, and first up, seat number one here is Mr. Shawn Yesner, yesnerlaw.com.
Thanks, Brandon. I appreciate being here again, as always. I'm going to talk about some new developments on the mortgage foreclosure front.
Interesting. Sounds fun. Let's dive into that. I also have Tim Converse, Solar Solutions, in studio. Welcome in, sir.
Thank you, Brandon. I'm here to talk about the benefits of solar. Right now, the pools are so cold right now, people just can't use them, and we can heat them up for you.
That's right. Also, Connor Anthony.
Yeah, it's good to be back in studio, Brandon. Thanks for having me, and welcome to the team, Tim, making his debut in studio. And Sean, it's good to see you in studio. You usually call in, but it's been a little while since we've been graced with your pretty face.
So. Yeah, thanks. Appreciate that.
In studio here. So yeah, let's. Before we jump into this content, I want to touch on a couple of hot listings that we've got, our listings of the month. We have a 414 South Royal Palm Way property. It's in Beach Park. It's a four-bedroom, three full-bath, two half-bath, and it's a gorgeous South Tampa property here in Beach Park. $1.29 million. At 414 South Royal Palm Way. Owners are motivated, and this is a beautiful property, just steps away from Swan Park in South Tampa. And also have another beautiful South Tampa property here as well, 4702 South Himes Avenue, available. It's a three-bedroom, one and one-half bath, $289,000, and it is a nice pool home. There's a pool in the backyard. Could use some of that solar heating there, possibly, Tim, and fenced-in yard as well. And it's 4702 South Himes Avenue in Tampa, Florida, one of the greatest places in the nation. I want to remind you to check us out on social media as well. We need some more YouTube subscribers. We're right at the 2,000 mark. Need a few subscribers on your YouTube channel. And also check us out on Facebook.com/REQB Show. And we have our second brand as well now, the Consumer Quarterback Show. So if you're a business owner out there, you're thinking about what are you going to do with your marketing dollars, we want you to take a look at our branding package, where we'll bring you on air, create these social media videos, some awesome content, answer those frequently asked questions that are so often answered in your business, and help you with your social media, press releases, a lot of cool things that we're doing here with the Real Estate Quarterback Show, and now our second brand, the Consumer Quarterback Show, Monday through Friday, 7 p.m. to 8 p.m., and we also have a weekend show on 102.5 The Bone as well on Sundays. So Mr. Yesner, Shawn Yesner, in studio here. He's financial solutions attorney, helping people with bankruptcies, loan modifications, short sales, general real estate questions. Seems like there's all types of questions that we throw your way from time to time.
It's always a problem with dirt, right?
That's right. Real property.
So I had a client come into the office earlier this week. It was an interesting situation. The client ended up losing their house in a foreclosure case, and it was an investment property, so it wasn't a situation where they were out of being in a home. Mm-hmm. But then the bank got paid by the mortgage insurance company, and then the mortgage insurance company sued the borrower to get repaid for the mortgage insurance company's losses in paying the bank. And I realized a lot of people get confused by that.
Right.
The mortgage insurance is paid for by the borrower, paid for by the person who pays the mortgage.
Yeah.
But it protects the bank.
Right.
And a lot of people don't understand that. And so when this guy is being chased now for a deficiency, he's saying, well, why was I paying all these premiums?
That's right.
Well, you don't understand. You're paying the premiums to protect the bank, not to protect yourself. And so we're just getting into the beginning stages of it. I think I got a few tricks up my sleeve. One of the interesting issues, he got a 1099 from the bank.
Mm-hmm.
And so I know there's a split of authority between the states. Florida hasn't decided the issue yet. But some states say when you get a 1099 for that waiver of debt, that forgiveness of debt income, that phantom income.
Phantom income, yep.
Some states say loan is satisfied, loan's gone. Bank, mm-hmm. you wrote it off, you waived it, you don't get to collect anymore. Other states say, nah, 1099 is just a piece of paper that reports to the IRS what's going on. Mm. Has no value outside of that. So I don't think Florida's made a decision yet on the issue, but I don't know, maybe I'll be the first.
Interesting, interesting. And that's that, just for you folks out there that may not understand exactly, you know, what we're talking about there. That's, you know, when you get that loan above, typically it's above 80% loan to value, that PMI that they call is private mortgage insurance. That's what Shawn Yesner here is referring to, is that PMI. So basically it looks like the bank's trying to maybe double end on that deal.
Yeah, so
double
what,
dip.
What happened was the loan was for, and I don't remember the exact numbers, let's call it 150 grand. Loan's for 150 grand.
Okay.
Property sells at foreclosure sale. Bank gets the property back. Bank then calls the insurance company and says, hey, we suffered a loss here. We got this house back, but it's not worth $150,000.
Mm-hmm.
So the insurance company then literally cuts a check to the bank. In this case, they cut a check for, I think it was like $70,000. And so the bank says, okay, we're owed $50. We got a check from the insurance company for $70. So we're fine. We're done. Then the insurance company goes back to the borrower and says, well, we sent the bank a check for 70, so we want that 70 back from you, mm-hmm. Mr. Borrower.
Wow.
And that's how the mortgage insurance works. And this particular borrower, who was a fairly intelligent guy, was completely confused. And I figured if he was, there's a lot of people out there that are confused as well.
Yeah, it's a space that people, you know, it's kind of like credit. You know, we're not taught it in school. We're not taught these financial decisions in school. And so there's no credit police out there running around helping citizens. It happens with these banks. You got the credit bureaus, a multi-billion dollar industry each year that, you know, sometimes they're entering into practices that may be considered bullying. And, you know, especially some of these big banks looking to double dip. I've always wondered about that on a short sale situation as well. Would the bank not accept an offer? Because I've dealt with a lot of short sales. I'm sure your office has as well. So when you see those offers come in and you think, wow, this is a reasonable offer, why would the seller not accept it? I was in the back of my mind, I'm thinking, well, probably because they want to get paid from the EMI company and then have the REO asset.
Yeah, probably. A lot of times what I'll say to people that come to me for a consultation is take common sense out.
Mm-hmm.
If you try to think in terms of common sense, you're just going to drive yourself crazy. This is not a common sense issue.
You can't handle the truth.
There you go. But, I mean, that's the situation. Sometimes I do think the banks look at it and say, wait a minute, we can take whatever on a short sale offer, or we can get paid, you know, this different amount, this more, a larger amount from mortgage insurance. And yeah, maybe they do go that way.
And then they take that asset back, and it's on their books as an REO. That's what it means. It's a real estate owned by the bank. And then now they give it to an REO broker, and they're appreciating like the market is.
Yeah. Now, the REOs do have some carrying costs with them as well. I mean, now the bank is responsible for the house until it sells, and there's a lot of times cleanup costs and all that other stuff. But, yeah, you're right. I don't think the banks are necessarily saying we want – Joe Smith's house, we want Mary Jones's house.
Mm-hmm.
But I think they are taking a look at it and saying, well, what are we going to get on the short sale versus what are we going to get from mortgage insurance? What are we going to get if we just flat out foreclose?
Yeah.
I think they are making those analysis. And now short sales are dropping, foreclosures are dropping, the market is starting to get back to a normal level. And mm-hmm. so I think the banks have now more time to make that analysis.
Yeah, it's an appreciating marketplace. Yeah. That's what you see with Tampa, St. Pete, Clearwater, a great place to live, work, and play. And so these banks know that, and they know that the appreciation is there. They see a lot of these investors coming in, and a lot of the investors are doing a renovation deal now, and they're sitting there, and they're going to be collecting rents.
Yep.
We've talked about Harvard studies where the rents are rising, and there's some things that you can do. And again, our show is based as a consumer advocate. If you just joined us, as Shawn Yesner, yesnerlaw.com. He's our financial solutions attorney, real estate attorney here, and does a lot of good in the community, well respected here. So if you're on the fence out there, if you've got debt, if there's things out there that you're facing, we want you pulling up our realestateradiotampa.com. Reach out and let us make these quality introductions for you. We want to quarterback these transactions and these introductions with the finest folks here in Tampa Bay. And we want you to think of this show as the hub of your financial wheel, with each spoke extending out, representing another one of our preferred partners, the absolute best in their space. And over 70 show partners now, ranging from CPAs, financial advisors. We've got five or six different types of law that are covered now with the show. So there's a lot of things that we can do to help you avoid the dumb tax, so to speak, and avoid a lot of that commission breath out there. We want to make you just a bit more street smart, and we don't care if you're climbing a corporate ladder, if you're throwing a ladder in your truck on the way to work, this show's for you. So more from our experts in studio and an interesting article out of the news press here when we come back. You're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show and realestateradiotampa.com.
This is Warwick Dunn, and you're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show, hosted by my man, Brandon Rhymes.
All right, welcome back. Thanks for sticking with us. Brandon Rhymes, host of the Real Estate Quarterback Show, and I'm the owner of Platinum MVP Realty. I'm a top listing agent here in Tampa Bay, featured in Florida Realtor Magazine multiple times, Tampa Bay Business Journal, recognized for my innovations with marketing, helping our sellers profit most on the sale of their real estate properties. So this segment is brought to you by part of my health team, which consists of Michael Vogt. He's an expert massage therapist here, Back In Health Massage, and he's been voted top in Tampa Bay massage services multiple times here with the Business Journal's awards. And shouts out to Michael Vogt. He's over at 3750 Gun Highway in Tampa. Does a great job on massage, stretching, several modalities of helping people feel better. So we appreciate him as well as all of our partners here. If you just joined us, you're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show here. I've got a couple of hot property listings I want to touch on. This one just reduced over $125,000. So if you're looking to build a home, or you're a builder developer out there, you got to check out this property at Zero Point Seaside Drive in Crystal Beach. It's overlooking the Ogden Bayou. So it's a waterfront property, got water views, and it's just reduced over $125,000. The current price is $350,000, and the properties surrounding you are multi-million dollar properties. Great homes, great neighborhood to live in. And also have a commercial property here at 1209 North Fort Harrison Avenue in Clearwater. This is a interesting property. It's grandfathered in as a gas station, and so there's a great opportunity for you to purchase this property at 1209 North Fort Harrison Avenue, $269,000. The owner told me there's a lot down the road going for $1 million just for the land. So we want you pulling up our website, realestateradiotampa.com. Bookmark that site, a plethora of resources. You can see all of our expert contributors there online at realestateradiotampa.com. And our consumer advocate hotline is 813-917-1894. If you want to get your home value, if you want to take a look at maybe getting out of a renting situation, no matter what you're facing, you've got $1 million to invest or you've got $100,000 in debt, we're here for you as a consumer advocate. We're going to help you with these financial decisions. So let's go ahead and shift gears here. We're going to talk about solar technologies, green technologies. You know, go green is the term that we've all heard, and, you know, protecting Mother Earth here, anything we can do to help with that. So I asked expert solar technology expert here, Tim Converse, with Solar Solutions in studio, expert contributor. What are you seeing out there, sir?
Well, what I'm seeing is we have a lot of products that help people bring value to their home, which is solar electricity, solar hot water. But with the weather patterns we're in right now, I think the thing that everybody's really grasping for is to heat their pool. And we're doing a lot of solar pool heating right now.
Yeah, we were talking in the green room before the show, and you were talking about, you know, it's the number one thing that you're seeing is people just heating pools. Secondary would be heating that water heater in their home to provide the hot water to the home. And then, you know, taking that a step further, it's talked about a lot, but less commonly used, maybe a little bit more expensive, is the actual solar panels on the roof that are going to provide electricity for the fuel or for the home.
Absolutely. That's the one we have the most conversations about. But right now, I guess we're really focusing on the pool heaters. There's about 500,000 swimming pools in a tri-county area that we run in, and about 10% of them are heated.
Wow.
And you can imagine spending $30,000 to $60,000 on a new pool, waiting 2 to 3 months to have it built. Your backyard's kind of torn up. Kids can't get in the backyard. Dogs can't play back there. And you finally get this behemoth concrete pond finished, and the pool's 64 degrees.
Yeah.
And that's really where we come into play. We do an installation that takes about 4 to 5 hours. And in 3 sunny days in a row, we've heated that pool in mid-80s, and everybody's loving life.
Yeah, that's, you know, you really want to enjoy it after you make that investment. You said you're doing some of the home shows. You're going to be out there this weekend at a home show as well. But a lot of the folks come up and they express that scenario to you.
Yeah, they're actually very disappointed because they've spent all that money on something that they thought was a great lifestyle and excitement level.
Yep.
And, you know, you got to make the toes happy first. So if you dip your toes in there and you're not happy, the rest of the body's not getting in. And most people like 85 to 88 degrees, and that's what we give them.
Yeah, let's talk about the, you know, in the Sunshine State here, right, the photovoltaic. I mean, what a great idea. And now you've got these units that you can install. They're affordable, and it's not only saving you money on a monthly bill, but it's also better for our environment.
Absolutely. And one of the things we bring to the table is all of our product lines are American-made. I think a lot of people have a great comfort level in that because there's a lot of overseas product that comes out that just doesn't last.
Mm.
But the product line we carry lasts 25 to 30 years, has a 25-year warranty on it, basically clips the tips on it. And basically what we're doing is we're taking advantage of the sun. We're changing out your meter. Your current meter only goes forward. And whether you have Duke or Tika, we end up changing out the meter. The meter will go backwards now. So as you're producing more power during the day than you're using, the meter spins backwards, and that's sending you money directly to you.
Wow, that's awesome. So sunny and 75 most of the time here in Florida, you know, in that range. You know, they have these studies that they do of the actual number of sunny days, because that's some, you know, you hear sometimes, well, what if it's a rainy day? You know, what if there's a couple cloudy days in a row? How does that affect? How does that play in?
It diminishes it a little bit, but you're still producing power. So even through the clouds, you get that. And really one of the things that really pushed people last year is they thought that 30% federal tax credit was going to go away, and they just replenished it. So whatever the gross of the system is, you get a 30% federal tax credit. That's off the top of what you owe. So if you get one this year in the 2016 taxes, you basically get a third off the system, which is great to take advantage of.
Wow. Yeah, take that over to Ronald Brace over at Brace Accounting. He's our show partner for all things tax and accounting as well. And, yeah, I mean, it's a great idea all around. You look at it, and, you know, on a personal note, we're building a property. We're looking at, you know, scheduling all the building, and you know, we've talked about it. But it really is one of those things when you price it in, you're going to pay a little bit more for the package and it, you know, than you could get away with building without it. But in the long run, that's where you're going to see the returns. Typically, now walk me through a basic scenario, typical scenario for you. When would people see returns, and how would that play out over their electric bill and also the tax rebates?
Well, you're talking about a couple different items here. As far as the tax rebates, those are for solar electricity and solar hot water.
Mm-hmm.
Those actually save you money, obviously monthly and over the year. So that's an immediate savings. As far as solar electricity, the return on investment is about 8.5 years.
Mm-hmm.
So a couple things you want to make sure we have in line. The person is going to stay long term in their house and has already made that commitment. And secondly, the roof's in good shape.
Okay.
Last thing you want to do is put a system on an older roof and then have them replace it in 2 to 3 years. There's a cost to take it down and put it back up. So these are the things when we sit down with people and kind of design the long term plan for them. And they definitely want to do that right.
Yeah, that's an important decision. That roof, you want to make sure it's been replaced or brand new. I mean, or within what, a couple of years,
three to five years.
Yeah. That's and if so, if you come into a situation where the property you see obvious deferred maintenance, that's something you would be shy against putting a system on.
Well, we actually prompt people to get their roof done earlier. You know, if you have 2 to 3 years left and this is something you want to commit to, let's just go ahead and change that roof out and have a fresh deck to work with.
Yeah, and if you're a roofer out there, you're a roofing company owner, we're looking for a partner that does roof. We have, from time to time with our real estate properties, you know, referrals and folks that we'd love to be able to refer out to. So we're looking for a roofing contributor, and it's been one of the toughest partners to bring in. It's interesting when you talk about roofing. It seems like they're all busy. They're all running around out there just slapping on roofs.
They're on fire. In fact, we work with about probably 24 to 25 of them.
Yep.
And they're not licensed to take the solar down and put it back up. So we do 4 to 10 of those a week where we take them down, put them back up. And then, of course, we obviously talk to the client. And if it's an old system, that's typically the time to change it out and put something fresh up there.
Yeah. If you just joined us, you're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show. That's Tim Converse with Solar Solutions. And also, first segment, we heard from Shawn Yesner, YesnerLaw.com. We're going to be coming up into our next segment. We're going to do in our Ask the RQB questions, where you can engage us online at social media utilizing the hashtag AskTheREQB. And we'll answer your questions online here on the show. So, and by the way, you can stream the show live if you are at a computer right now. You can pull it up at realestateradiotampa.com. Just hit the live stream link. You can watch us in studio here. We've got some awesome cameras and great service provided by Tampa Bay Multimedia. Shouts out to John Gaston and Josh Vazda there as well. So, yeah, Tim, what else are you seeing out there when it comes to solar? You know, what maybe let's talk about, you know, what have been some of the holdbacks, you know, over the past 3 to 5 years, maybe 7 years going back. You know, was it Tico Power? Was it some of these industries that have been in power so long? Like, it just seems like solar should be so much bigger in Florida than it is. And at least if you look at some of the past studies I've seen, where I think New Jersey or some other, you know, states are ahead of us in terms of total units or total output.
Well, the things that had held people back 5-7 years ago was the value of their house.
Mm-hmm.
You're looking at a house that maybe is worth $300,000 in their mind or in the reports, and then goes down to $230,000, $210,000. And a lot of people don't want to invest long-term in a house like that. Now that the values have started to come back up, People are wanting to invest more long-term in their house. So that's been a good thing. Florida used to have a rebate program, and it was so successful they ran out of money, which just tells you the story that if there's rebates and credits, people do move forward with these programs.
Wow. Yeah, it makes sense. And you know, you hear some things, too, about maybe the power of the TECO lobby and kind of pushing some of the efforts back and things like that we've talked about before on the show. But yeah, you know, it's interesting. You look at it, you look at solar, you look at John Grant with Eagled LED. He does the Eagle lighting, the LED lighting. There's so many choices now as consumers where you can make the choice that's going to be better not only for your efficiency but also for Mother Earth. And so when we come back, we're going to hear more from Shawn Yesner, our financial solutions attorney here in studio. We're going to be taking your questions off the Ask the REQB segment, as well as Tim Converse, Solar Solutions, and more from our contributor or co-host here, Connor Anthony. So stay with us. The best is yet to come.
This is Warwick Dunn, and you're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show, hosted by my man, Brandon Rimes.
Back. Thanks for sticking with us. Appreciate you tuning in to the show. Brandon Rimes here, host of the Real Estate Quarterback Show, Intelligent Talk Radio. I've got some intelligent folks here in studio with me. Mr. Shawn Yesner of Yesner Law, Tim Converse, Solar Solutions, and Connor Anthony, co-host on the show. And this segment is brought to you by Total Title Solutions. They are our title partner for real estate closings. Total Title Solutions, they do a great job of closing our real estate properties, doing the title searches, lien searches, making sure there's not any encumbrances on your property. And they can also help you if you're a for sale by owner out there. Just reach out directly to them or go through our consumer advocate hotline at 813-917-1894. Or you can also call us, check out Real Estate Radio Tampa.com. All right, so let's go ahead and now what we're going to do is we have a Ask the REQB segment where we want to engage you off of social media. You can check us out at Twitter at BrandonRhymes1, on Facebook.com/RealEstateQuarterbackShow, and other places that we're at online, of course, LinkedIn, Instagram, all the major sites. We'd love for you to check out our YouTube channel where you can see all of our past shows and previous shows with St. Petersburg Mayor Rick Kreisman, Tampa Mayor Bob Buckhorn, as well as Warwick Dunn interview, awesome interview with Warwick Dunn online as well. So let's go ahead and tee up those questions for him, Connor.
All right, cool. Thanks, Brandon. And the first one's coming to Tim. It's from Nancy off of Real Estate Radio Tampa. And Nancy asks, how does the solar heating process work when it's nighttime or it's raining or if it's just not sunny outside? Will my pool still be heated?
Well, that's a great question. In the winter months, basically, we provide you with a winter blanket, November, December, January, and February. And then the other outside months, basically, the outside air temperature is warm enough, so you really have a lot of heat loss. You might lose 4 or 5 degrees at night, sun kicks on the next day, and you're heated back up. So really, it's not a problem.
All right, awesome. And this one's coming from Jason off of Facebook, and this is coming to Sean. And Jason asks, I might have to sell my home in a short sale. How can I expect this to affect my credit and my finances? Would this be something that I have to declare bankruptcy because of?
Yeah, and it's another good question, and not necessarily. I think the first thing that I would do once the short sale's over is refer to one of our other show partners, Mr. Crowley, the credit magician.
William Crowley, yeah.
And get the credit cleaned up that way. But no, a short sale is not going to be a permanent barrier to credit. Typically, credit recovers within 2 to 3 years, and people can buy a house again after 2 to 3 years, depending on what type of loan program. And in order to get the short sale, we have to prove some type of hardship to the bank, whether that be financial, whether that be medical, something that happened that we can justify the short sale. So it doesn't always mean that we're going down the path to a bankruptcy. It might if the person has exorbitant credit card bills or IRS debt or student loan debt or other things that are crushing them financially. Maybe a bankruptcy is appropriate, but yeah. One doesn't always necessarily lead to the other.
Yeah, or job loss. You know, a lot of times right. You see job loss. It's one of the effects that we saw on a national level, on a macro level, you know, with Obamacare and different things. They, you know, a lot of the pundits talk about, a lot of people point out, is that you had a lot of people moving to a more of a part-time situation, cutting their hours back from 40 maybe to 25 so they can slide in underneath those requirements for certain government-mandated programs.
Right, now. Right. Obamacare and some of this other stuff. Typically, to get a short sale, all we really need to show is that income has gone down for some reason mm-hmm. or expenses have gone up for some reason. Or some combination of both. So drop in hours, loss of job, medical, a death of one of the borrowers, disability of one of the borrowers, all those different issues factor in. And there's been times where I've had to be creative in my hardship
yep.
with the bank. But, you know, never lying to the bank, never being dishonest with the bank. But
right.
that's what you pay the attorneys to do is be creative with the reason for the hardship.
That's right. Yeah, as long as you can back it up with a paper trail, you know, you write as a seller of a property and you want to do a short sale, you're going to be writing a hardship letter. Thank you. And so that's going to outline, you know, kind of what you saw, what happened, and it's going to allow you to basically you get, especially if it's your primary residence, you're going to be able to get out of that property. You're not going to have to pay the difference, that deficiency, that phantom income that we were talking about in
right.
segment one. But yeah, you know, so there's so many options out there. The thing I see happen so much out there is that people will they'll rob from their retirement to pay credit cards, or they'll rob from their retirement to try to stay on point with this loan. That if you bought it, it's just when you bought it. A lot of yeah. things you do in life is timing. It's, you know, did you buy the real estate in 05 or 04, 05, 06 in that time frame? Then you bought it at a high peak, and now once the market's reset, it's not your fault.
Yeah, and I get it, and I respect it. There's people out there with the mindset of, I borrowed the money, I'm going to pay it back. And that's
right.
That's fine. That's fine for people to think that way. It's where you start to invade the 401k, the IRA, assets that are exempt,
mm-hmm.
assets that creditors can't touch. You know, I have the benefit of not being emotional. I have the benefit of not having that same, it's not my, you know, compass here at play. It's
right.
It's me giving advice to the client. So a lot of times I can take that emotion out of it and say, I get it. I understand why you want to go into your 401k. But if you go into your 401k now, it's not going to be there for you later where the creditors can't touch it. They can't get at it.
Yeah, let's not rob our retirement, and you know, let's not. When you're older, you're at your 65 or 70 point, and you want to retire. Now you've taken that money to pay down a bank's asset. that, you know, you may have bought it at the wrong time. But if you just joined us, you're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show. We've got attorney Shawn Yesner here in studio, yesnerlaw.com, as well as 10 Converse with Solar Solutions, Inc., talking about how we can help you from a financial standpoint. If you've got loan modifications, bankruptcy, short sales, any kind of real estate issues happening out there, you know, we want to help you with these types of issues, as well as you know, if you're building a home, or if you've got an existing home with a pool, or you want to take a look at these options, Tim Converse with Solar Solutions, he'll come out and, you know, give you this consultation. I think, you know, sometimes it's free, sometimes he has a charge for it, but you know, Tim, typically we go down and sit down with the homeowner and meet them at their home and take a look at their pool and give them their options.
That's exactly what we do. And actually, there's no charge to come out. So okay. Myself or any of my reps will come out there and design a system for their specific needs. It works out really well.
Okay. The example we were talking about earlier was interesting. I don't know if you want to talk about that on air with the – I think it was, you went over to a WWF wrestler's home and talked to him about his potential options, and it was maybe on a show or something like that. Is right?
I was on a reality show called Total Divas, so I went out there and great fit for us. But yeah. We had a good time. They wanted to talk about you know, reducing the electric bill, so we gave them some options out there and looked at heating the pool. So it worked out really well for us.
Very cool. Yeah, well, let us know when that comes about, and we'll post it on the blog, and that'll be interesting, Connor. We can post that out there, right?
Yeah, that'd be really interesting to see. And I'm just kind of curious as to, you know, like, solar power is becoming like the big, like the hot thing, the end thing, the green energy. How long does it typically take for people to, I guess, make their money back on how much they're saving by switching to this solar energy?
It's probably the biggest question we get, because it is an investment. It's an investment in your house and your future.
Yep.
The return on investment is about 8.5 years. And we're really excited about that, because not long ago it was 12 to 15 years. The price has come down about 30% in the past 5 or 6 years. So it's become very, very affordable. And so it's about 8.5 year return on investment. And after that 8.5 years, you're paying yourself, whether it's $150 to $300 a month. So when you look at investments, it's absolutely spectacular.
It's great to point that out, too, that you use American products. You know, my hat's off to you for using these American products.
Well, that's the way we run our whole business, and everything we do is like that. Probably the other thing that we get questions on is, I've got this beautiful brand new roof, and, you know, what about this? I spent $30,000 on this roof, and you're going to punch holes in it.
Right.
Obviously, the process is a little bit stronger than that, but all of the mounts in the roof are stainless steel. We use a great sealant. We have our own crews. They're all factory trained, so it's not just some guys up there doing their thing. It's some factory trained guys that know what they're doing.
Yeah, that's it. That's good. That's important to note. Yeah, so, you know, this is Intelligent Talk Radio, where you want to be your hub of your financial wheel with all these different concerns you have. We want you to focus on being a good, you know, teacher, maybe you're a doctor, maybe, you know, we want you to focus on being good at what you do and turn to these decisions, these different types of buying decisions, or maybe, you know, you have these real estate decisions that you're concerned about. We want you to turn to us and let us help you quarterback these introductions and go against the nonsense in the mainstream media. You know, we turn on different channels, and it's, you know, you got left and right, you know, got all these different things happening. We want you to turn off that news, program in our realestateradiotampa.com, watch our live streams, check out our YouTube channels for a plethora of information, blog sites, websites with all these informations that we can help you to live a better life. That's the goal of this show. And Connor, we're looking for some expert contributors out there still for certain categories. We got these monthly parties that we have, a good time to come out and meet some of our other partners as well.
Yeah, we do 2 monthly gratitude parties every month. It's usually the second and last week of the month down here at iHeart Media, and they're from 5:30 to 8:30 p.m. And we invite anyone who wants to come out, any consumers, any prospective partners. It's a good time. We've got it catered by our catering partner, Catering by the Family. We had some bacon wrapped plantains last time, some really good empanadas.
Yeah.
And I actually, the day after the gratitude party, my mom went to a party that was catered by Catering by the Family, and they brought home some of their Cubans, which are really good.
Wow.
It's just a fun time to come hang out, socialize. You know, we provide everything. There's no cost to you. If you're interested in, you know, learning more, just reach out to us on realestateradiotampa.com. Little side, you can just shoot us a message, and I personally will get back to you on that.
Yeah, that's right. You can submit the form there. It comes to us just like an email. So just go to realestateradiotampa.com, submit the form, And we'd love to give you two free tickets to the next party that we have. I think it's on April 1st is our next gratitude party here at iHeart. And we're also doing a lunch and learn on the 6th, I believe. But, yeah, so, hey, when we come back, we're going to talk about more from our experts in studio. We're going to go through our Tell Me Something Good segment. So we got attorney Shawn Yesner in studio, financial solutions attorney, and Tim Converse with Solar Solutions. You're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show and RealEstateRadioTampa.com.
This is Work Done, and you're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show hosted by my man, Brandon Rhymes.
Welcome back. Thanks for sticking with us. Brandon Rhymes here, host of the Real Estate Quarterback Show. I'm the owner of Platinum MVP Realty, and we are looking for a few select sales associates to come on our team as realtors. Got a lot of leads flowing and need some help with these buyer leads coming in. But also flying in the friendly skies with Captain Will Smith. I got to give shouts out to Tampa Executive Airport, Captain Will Smith, teaching me how to fly up there and have a great time going up and learning the aeronautical side of this great planet Earth that we're on here. A lot of fun up there, and we have a lot of fun with the show. Over 70 show partners now, ranging from CPAs, financial advisors, five or six different types of attorneys covering different types of law, solar, home remodeling, new home specialist, all of the best folks here in Tampa Bay that you can request a introduction to simply by calling our consumer advocate hotline at 813-917-1894. You can text or call that number. It's 813-917-1894.
You used to call me on my cell phone.
And you can also visit realestateradiotampa.com. paralegals.com. And before we jump back into this great content, I want to touch on a couple of hot listings that we've got. I've got Zero Whippoorwill Drive in Holiday. This is shouts out to any builders, developers, anybody wanting to buy property and potentially build on it. This is only $299,000 for 7.25 acres. Beautiful property here. It's got some water views at Zero Whippoorwill Drive in Holiday. Also, Zero North Jasmine Avenue in Tarpon Springs. This is another buildable property. It's a design and build option. You got 4 bedrooms, 3 1/2 baths, ready to be built for you at $399,000 here in beautiful Tarpon Springs, and part of the best place in the United States to be living, working, and playing.
No shoes, no shirt, and no problem.
All right, so let's go ahead around the horn. We've got Shawn Yesner here, YesnerLaw.com, Financial Solutions, Real Estate Law, Bankruptcy, and also Tim Converse, Solar Solutions as well here in studio. So let's go ahead. What we're going to do now is we're going to enter our lightning round. All right, the lightning round, top consumer tips, things to do, things to avoid. Mr. Shawn Yesner, you're up first.
Yeah, I think my first consumer tip, if you have someone, a borrower, who is concerned about what's going on with my income, what's going on with my house, what's going on with my expenses, I just lost my job, or some other issue like that, I think the first call they should make is actually to their mortgage company. Mm-hmm. I do think mortgage companies really don't want to foreclose. Mm-hmm. So first call is to the bank. If the bank doesn't do any good, then maybe pick up the phone, give me a buzz. But I think first, call the bank, see what the bank can do to help.
Yeah, absolutely. And YesnerLaw.com, I'm sure you got a plethora of resources there available as well. Tim Converse, Solar Solutions.
Well, one of the things that we talk about is safety around the pool. And I think a lot of people forget that when they build these swimming pools that they have a commitment for safety around there. Let's make sure the gates are closed. Let's make sure we have layers of protection out there, whether they're alarm systems or gates around them. And let's make sure these young kids that are around the pool know how to swim.
Yeah, hey, that's great. We hate to hear those sad stories that happen sometimes around the pool. You know, the kid didn't have his swimmies on like me. I almost drowned when I was little. I didn't have, remember those little balloons that you had? They look kind of like this, but it's like a plastic, or not a plastic. It's a like a foam material. I jumped in without it.
They still have them. Yep.
Do they still have them?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And I can. You know, it's one of those weird. You know, you're about. Gosh, how old was I? 7, 8, 9 years old. I remember just maybe younger than that. I'm looking up. I'm just like, now what do I do?
Yeah, my wife, who I may have tune out during this part of the program here, still wears them. Mm-hmm. Still wears them in the water.
Yeah, you got to be safe, man. Yeah. You know, safety, be safe. And I wasn't sure. All right, and we got Connor. You got a tip?
Yeah, I guess just my thing would be like explore your options. Like I had no idea that you know, you could actually heat pools with solar technology. And people might hear the like, oh, in 8 years before I make money, that's a long time. But you have to think, if you own a house and you know invest $60,000 in a pool, you're probably going to be living in that house for more than 8 years. So at some point, you better get some money back to you. And, you know, like what Sean's saying, like, you know, there are ways, you know, just kind of if like I had it, my mom had to short sell her house back about 5 years ago, and I wasn't familiar at all with the process. And I, you know, like when I hear short sell, I was like, are we going to go bankrupt? Like, what's going to happen now? And it was just, you know, kind of just know where you can go from it, just because you think something might be bad. If you can get, you know, the right help, it doesn't mean it will be bad.
Yeah, and also another point with the solar, when you add solar, you're just going to help your resale value if you do happen to move, you know, with that stuff already installed. It's you know, for a buyer, they're going to say, wow, it's already done for me. It's already in the home. So let's go ahead and enter our Tell Me Something Good segment. Now, what we want to do with this segment is, you know, there's so much sensationalism and negativity in the mainstream media, you know. We, with the Real Estate Quarterback Show, and our second show is the Consumer Quarterback Show, we want to be different. We want to provide you these positive stories, things happening in the local community and on a national scale sometimes that can, you know, provide that positivity. There's, you know, how much of the negativity in the mainstream media, especially during this election cycle, you know, a 24/7 nauseating electric cycle that we're going through right now for the elections. But yeah, so let's go ahead and jump into our Tell Me Something Good segment. Sean?
Yeah, so a couple of years ago, I went to the doctor for my physical, and my sugar was off the charts, and my weight was off the charts. And so doctor said, you got two choices, get in shape or start taking insulin shots. So mm-hmm. I started running, mm-hmm. and I've done Gasparilla, I've done Turkey Trot, I do maybe 5 or 6 or 7 5K races every year. I run every week, and I'm really excited. I'm a huge fan of Jeff Vinnick. Never met the man before, but I am a huge fan of what he is and what he's done for this community. Yeah. And so I'll be running in the Bolt Run, which is Saturday, March 26th. We start at 7 in the morning. We start and end at Amalie Arena. Beautiful run through the Channel Side and downtown Tampa areas. But I'll be running the 5K for the Bolt Run, which benefits the Lightning Foundation.
Very cool. There's some energy around you, so it makes that run easier, right?
Yeah. It's a lot of fun running with people.
People cheering you on and just interesting in the beautiful scenery downtown. Yeah, they've done a great job with that.
Yep, and you get a Lightning ticket, or you get two Storm tickets for registering Bolt Run.
Awesome. Tell me something good. Tim?
Well, we're very excited to be part of a program which teaches swim lessons. It's called the World's Largest Swim Lesson, and it's a Guinness World Book program that happens in June. We've done it for the past, 5 or 6 years, and it's done through the Florida Swimming Pool Association. And we teach a lot of disadvantaged children how to swim. They might not have a swimming pool at their house, but they might go to someone else's house. They might be by a lake or something like that.
Yeah.
So the knowledge is very important. And it's just one of those things that you got to teach them. So if the issue comes up, they're prepared.
Yeah, the younger the better, right?
Yeah, it's a great program.
Yeah, Lydia, I used to work with at a restaurant. I thought it was cool because, she just put on Facebook yesterday that her daughter was in some contest through her school and won a college scholarship for coming in some, I don't know if it was a science fair or what, but she was super proud. And, she said her daughter was like real going to another round of it. So, I mean, getting a college scholarship, you can't really get much better than that.
Yeah, that's awesome. All right, and I'll give shouts out to Warwick Dunn Charities. We had the opportunity to have Warwick on the show some time back, and what an interesting gentleman that he's grown up to be. He won the 2004 Walter Payton Man of the Year, 147 homes to date that he's helped single parents gain home ownership through his down payment assistance, and he works in conjunction with Habitat for Humanity. We had an opportunity about a year ago to go up to Dade City and document one. It's on our YouTube channel as well. You can see the video on our YouTube channel where we went up and documented the home giveaway. It was a very cool. The note behind the story is that these folks, when they do get to the point where they are the recipient of a home, a lot of times they've donated up to 500 hours or so of service to helping other people's with their homes. So it's a really cool thing that happens in this local community. And also Warwick's part owner of the Atlanta Falcons, so he's doing a lot up in the Atlanta area, back in New Orleans where he's from. But shouts out to Warwick Dunn.
Warwick Dunn. Warwick spins to the 10. He's to the 5. 4-2. Touchdown.
All right. So let's just open it up to general conversation. When we look at real estate in Tampa Bay, things happening. You got, financial solutions that you can look at. And you got solar options as well. There's a lot of things you can do. So that's what this show's been heavy on. But, parting words of advice?
Well, it's interesting to have me and Tim on the show at the same time. You think, what do we have in common? Mm-hmm. We're actually having the same conversation with the potential clients. I know Tim said a couple times, what are the long-term plans for the house?
Mm-hmm.
It's not worth it to get the solar on there if they have a short-term plan. They're going to be out 1, 2, 3 years. I have the same conversation with them. Are we going to keep the house long-term, in which case let's talk about modification options? Or are you going to get out of that house within 2, 3 years, in which case maybe we talk about short sale options?
Right. Yeah, it's all about having that plan, that developing that game plan, kind of giving you a helicopter view here with the Real Estate Quarterback Show and making you more street smart. And there's so many things to consider when you talk about the legacy that you're going to be leaving for your kids. That's important when you think about it. Tim?
Yeah, and we work with a lot of mortgage brokers because what happens is you're looking at a property and they send us out there before they even purchase the property.
Yep.
They say, am I solar feasible? And if they are, basically we'll design a package for them. We can work with the mortgage broker and actually just have a side check from the mortgage broker. So basically it's part of your mortgage. The rates are so spectacular these days that it makes sense to get it that way.
That's right. We want to help you call an audible.
Omaha! Omaha!
Super Bowl winner Peyton Manning there helping us call that audible and help you live a better life. That's the goal of this show. So we want you tuning in each day. We're here 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. here on 1250 Winds, and we got a weekend show as well on an FM station. And so, thanks so much for coming in. Thanks to all our listeners, our viewers out there. We're getting a lot of viewers now on our live stream show with WeBeam TV and Tampa Bay Multimedia. And so, thanks for tuning in. Check out our websites, realestateradiotampa.com. We got a blog site out there, and you can catch all of our repurposed content on our YouTube channel as well. So stay with us, and we're going to be back here same time and place. And please consider committing a random act of kindness.